What's going on? It's Vinny here, and welcome to this react to old videos type vlog, but I want to make it a little bit different. This video has been requested quite a bit, but I know a lot of people have done this before, but I thought I'd change it up a little bit. So instead of just going through and picking some random videos here or there, I'm going to pick the videos that kind of like define my channel in a way, and we're going to do like the story of Minilad from back when I started 4.5 years ago onto the present day. So my friend and I, we made this PNG at the top that basically shows start of my channel, all the little milestones, and the red bar that's going to come across is where in the channel's life the video that we're watching is. A little bit different, but I think it could be a little bit cool. So let's jump into this. First video, my first ever video on this channel, period. Modern Warfare 2, I've shown a little bit of it before. I'm not going to show the full entire video, all the videos, because we're probably here all night. So if you guys want to watch the full thing, all the videos will be in the description. But we're going to show a little bit here and there, just to kind of get a flavor of sort of what I was doing and whatnot. So, first video. God, I hate this. This one really brings up my accent. Okay. Also, this video is privatized. I have like 100 videos privatized. This is one of them because I just cannot stand my voice. I can stand my voice now, but because I had the accent, I'm just like, oh, it's cringy as shit. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Oh God. That intro. Listen.
What is up, guys? It is Minilad here, bringing you a 5-to-1 clutch.
I'm so quiet. I can't. My accent.
A couple more videos on there. I had a.
I'm very. I was very quiet and shy. Okay. Leave me be.
Such as HD PVR. And then the moment just sort of arises where my mom needs one to
record videos
and stuff like that. So I just thought, right, may as well go and persuade her to get one for me. And so fair enough, it did.
I can't.
I'm not a pro Xboxer as such.
Xboxer, boys!
I think I'm on 2 kills so far. Look around there, and there's no one here. And then I'm going to get the last 3. Quick enough succession.
I'm 1.5 minutes in. And I listen.
Yeah.
I don't know what to talk about!
Now it's just got released.
Shot! Out.
There's contracts, there's so many kill streaks, etc.
Shot! Put me in phase! Boom!
Anyway, my video's coming to an end, so subscribe, please, if you want.
Please!
I shall see you guys later.
And there it is! That is the start of something beautiful. Where did it all go wrong? So then after that video, I did some like, I kept doing the commentaries and whatnot. This is a good one. One of the reasons my channel kind of blew up to begin with was I has Cupquake. You guys may know her now. She's on maybe 3.5, 3.6 million subs. Tiff, really, really, really good person. And back in November 2011, she had this thing, a series called Piece of Quake, where she did like, she basically had like a daily vlog type thing. And then she had this segment called Gamer of the Week. And I was her Gamer of the Week back in 2011. And that was back when I had 300 subs. Watch this.
The Gamer of the Week.
Also, shout out to Tiff for letting me use this. Remember, November 2011.
So, this week's Gamer of the Week is Minilad.
Yay!
And he has
look at that channel.
Battlefield 3,
also look, I still have the same logo from 337 subs.
All sorts of other games.
Same logo. I've had it the whole time.
350-ish subs, and I could tell that he puts a lot of work into his channel. He really loves
love you, Tiff.
He loves to help others. He has his most recent video is kind of giving advice on how to.
Giving advice, me, 300 subs, me giving advice. Yep, that was me. So I think for that video, I have like 300 subs, like 700 subs, like overnight. I remember like screaming, like, because obviously when you double in subs, no matter what sub size you're on, you're like, ah, it's happening. I've been doing YouTube since 2009. So my other channels, I've never got past 20 subs. So for me to get 300 was like, whoa. And then for me to go 300 to 700, I was like, whoa. So we're going to go on to the next one, which is called The Journey. So I did a lot of like COD commentary and like Minecraft Let's Plays and whatnot, but then I kind of sort of figured out like, hey, like I didn't know if I really wanted to do like Minecraft Let's Plays and whatnot, call commentaries all the time. And me and my friend Tesserai, Josh, if you're watching this, I love you so much, buddy. He's the first sort of internet friend I had, you know, because obviously like when you start YouTube, you kind of go around, find channels you like, make friends and whatnot. And he was the first proper friend that I had online. And me and him, we played Minecraft Let's Plays together. We did skits and everything together. Really good guy. But sadly, he did school and whatnot. He quit at 1,000 subs. We made this Minecraft skit called The Journey. Everything here is just extremely nostalgic for me. Let's give this a watch. Oh, yes. Nostalgia is real.
Welcome to life.
basically like a guy waking up in the middle of nowhere and figuring out life. Step into the portal to begin your life has a really sort of deep meaning to it, you know? This is the kind of shit we came up with. The music sync. This is the beginning of your life. Throughout your life, you will learn new skills. Eventually, you will find a sign that will tell you the meaning of life. Good luck. And then he just goes about as he would, like, trying to figure out this new world that he's sort of been thrown into. It brings back so many good memories. Just chilling, making good videos that you enjoy. Here we go, boys. I know you don't know what's coming. I know what's coming. Congratulations, you found the meaning of life. To find the meaning of life, read the sign on the red wool behind you. Thank you for playing. Look up.
Finish him.
What the fuck?
It like that. It's like, just the biggest fuck you I think I've ever done. Then from this video, then a thing called trolling came around. Trolling was huge back in like 2011 because it was like a new thing. No one's ever really done it before. Like, hey, you can piss people off and it's kind of funny. Which now looking back on it was kind of a dick move and is a serious dick move. And I don't know why I did it, but I was a troller. I made trolling videos. We're gonna watch my second ever trolling video. The first one had copyrighted music. This is how old this was. That font, though.
My name is E-Double. Their name is PJ Harvey.
Yes! The quality is so bad. Like, really bad. And you're literally... If you guys haven't been on YouTube long enough to know this stage of YouTube, this is literally find as many ways on COD as possible to piss people off. So just trap someone in a corner, fly your helicopter around and look at them. And they can't get out. They're trapped in that corner. They can't jump over that table. I was such an asshole. Looking back now, I'm just like, I kind of hate myself for these. E-double. Oh, that dank meme. Oh my god. This is just great. It's the British lobbies were absolutely amazing. These memes, though. The troll faces! Also, yeah, this is a spawn point. If you put yourself in the door and put a helicopter here, they're literally trapped. Because you can't jump over the railing. I remember trying to get this clip. It took me so long to get this clip, like days to get this clip alone. I included so many of those because that was the cool thing. Back in 2011, those faces were cool, okay? Nowadays, not so much. Not so much. GG, boys. Round of applause. Amazing. I was a dick. I was a straight-up asshole, and I'm sorry. Around the same time as the trolltage, as we started to do Call of Duty Funny Moments, which is one of the reasons that I started to get recognized and people started to watch my videos because they really enjoyed these funny moments, because funny moments wasn't really a thing before. Nowadays, it's everywhere. Nowadays, you see like funny moments in the title when it's just like 3 hours of gameplay and you're like, not really how it works, but this is OG funny moment stuff. Modern Warfare 3 moment, episode 1. This is the time, you know, Ninja Defuses. So very golden. Now this Ninja Defuse, this was literally the 407 Defuse. We tried this for like 2 months straight and no one's ever got it. And then Scott finally did it. Watch this. What you do is on this map, you lie on top of the bomb. Best Ninja Defuse I've ever seen.
No fucking way! Oh my
Scott,
god.
We tried that for months. I love you, Scott, for doing that. He was just sitting there as well.
Good, I am turkey.
You bitch!
And Scott's always been a screamer.
I repeated you.
This one. This is where the crew got this idea back in 2011. How many times can you kill yourself in a game of domination? Look at the scoreboard. Suicide Walter, 477 deaths. This is the shit we did. I remember this game. That's where that all began. So from there, I did call commentaries for like maybe a good 6 months. And the next video I want to show you is like, it's a 3v3 Riot Shield on Modern Warfare 3. But it starts to show you like where I started editing and where I really started to enjoy editing. So I remember this video came out August 9th, 2012, right? This took me so long because I didn't really know how to edit at the time. And this video took me so long to try and figure out like how I wanted to do this. Yes. This is so nostalgic for me! Yes! Basically, it was 3v3, and we tried to see who would win in like a 3v3 RPG battle. Simple as that, but I made it as epic as possible. And this is where I found my love for like production music. I was still in secondary school and high school making this. Boom! The timing! This brings back so many memories. This took me so long because I really didn't know. Oh, that shot though! This took me so long to edit because I didn't really know how to edit. I remember making this. Yes! This is so good. I love that cinematic. I was so proud of this video. I remember showing this to like friends at school and like my parents and stuff. Like, hey, look what I did!
Oh, they're coming down right here. They're coming down here.
Hear the epic music.
Yes! Conway! Oh, I miss Conway so much. And Meg. The two people in this video. H2O Delirious is online. And this is what? Mid-2012. God damn. You progress as a content creator. I know so many ways I can make this better.
Run away.
Oh, he's trying to throw a knife.
Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes! Brilliant. I love that so much.
This is where
I really started to love editing. Okay, so from 2012, we're gonna go on to 2013. This one is kind of glorious. True story, the first time I ever got recognized as a kid came up to me, 2013 PAX East, or PAX Prime, and was like, oh my God, are you the drunk guy? This is from these videos. So what I used to do is I used to go out with my friends to bars and clubs and whatnot, and then come back and my friends would record me drunk as shit. For a long time, I was known as the drunk guy. So this is actually Nogla recording this. It's Nogla's video, but Nogla let me upload it. So thank you, Nogla, for letting me upload this. If you guys haven't seen this, you are in for a treat. Oh, and the outro, oh, the intro, sorry. The,
all right, what's
the classic
on?
Intro.
Somebody here, and it kind of happened again. went out with a few friends, decided to come back.
So it kind of happened again.
YouTubers. Brilliant idea, said no one ever. But definitely big thanks to Nogla for recording this and making this video. So please go check him out if you haven't already. His link will be in the description. And like, subscribe, all that stuff. And I will see you guys later.
See, I've had the outro for that long as well.
Xbox Live drunk. Well, 1, hurt your KD. And 2, you might end up in a video like this. So, don't do it.
My old Marcel appeared. Hi, Marcel.
I was so gone.
Hey, drunk me, lad.
Sorry.
I will be the judge of me, and I say no.
I'm so gone. Oh my God.
I will murder you.
Okay.
No, Glut, you're being a passage blocker.
Passage blocker.
Racist, Nogla.
Passage blocker, boys.
Meelad, just go around. Just go around.
He got through absolutely.
Okay, so before we do this, before we get into this, I remember we were talking about the Great American Challenge, which is like a 20-inch dildo. Don't ask me why, but this is the backstory of this.
Imagine if you were a girl and that just went all through your insides, like, that shit would ruin everything. It's a game changer for your body. But it's a game changer. Because, like, please repeat after me. Chong Ching La.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Everybody in the lobby repeat. Konnichiwa. Okay. This is the lesson over. Have a good day, children.
And I die. This one is said by many is my best ever video. If you guys don't know about this is back in, what was it? April 23rd, 2014. We started to do sandbox videos. Sandbox was not a thing on YouTube at the time. We thought it'd be kind of cool because a lot of us kind of did skit-based stuff that we would go on sandbox and try and make our own scenes and whatnot. So, Dragon Ball Z sandbox. This, if you guys haven't seen this is a classic video, and it's the video that I still think I've never laughed as hard in my life. We're gonna start at the end up. The ending is the classic part. The start is still really, really funny, so I recommend you guys to watch it if you haven't, or if you have, you can watch it again. It's the ending that so many people will say, put down in history is probably one of their best moments in my videos.
Vegeta said my chromosomes are over 90.
Anthony!
Are you mad? Yeah. Why? Because I can't see my forehead.
Hey guys, I learned a new attack while training. It's called Special Needs Cannon.
Probably one of my favorite recording sessions of all time.
I put my eyes like this so I can see enemies coming from any direction.
Wait, is this it? This is it. This is the clip. This will go down in history. It's probably one of my best videos, I think. Voted by people. At this point, I fell off my chair. I was in fetal position under my desk.
2 hours later.
We cut it out, but we were literally laughing for like 10 minutes straight. And then.
Oh man, Krillin.
What the fuck is going on?
I can't even breathe.
Guys, listen.
He just frisbees into the sunset.
He just frisbees into the sunset.
That to me is probably one of my favorite videos I've ever done. So then onwards, we're gonna fast forward a little bit. There's a lot of videos in there that I haven't included. So obviously, if you guys wanna go back and just have a little trip of your own, if you guys have been subbed to me for a while, you can go back and sort of nostalgia all over your face yourself. That sounded wrong, but I don't care. Anyway, so we're gonna go on. We're gonna watch the first ever Ask Mini. Ask Mini now is probably my most requested series, which is really cool because it's sort of a solo series. So you guys can actually tolerate with my shit. So this one is my first ever Ask Mini. This is where the Mini Lad Rap God came from.
Alright, what's going on YouTube? It's Mini here. Welcome to the first ever Ask Mini. How fast can you do Rap God? Well, because YouTube is the
best website in the world and it is amazing in every way.
Livers coming at you with supersonic speed. Summon, you assuming I'm a human, but I gotta do to get it through to you. I'm superhuman and never rubble so that anything you say is ricocheting on me and it'll glue to you. And if it's the day, never starting out again, the motherfucking onions have been like it, living and never bending. And another hit is up a river when it pulls the thing is half a little bit celebrating because another way to get it motivated to make elevated music. You make elevated music. Oh, he's too mainstream, but that's what they do and they can yell at the confusing.
So, I am for the first ever Ask Mini. We're gonna go forward and we're gonna do the America blog. Now, there's obviously a lot of gaming ones here that I skipped out, like I said before. We're gonna go to the America blog because this is kind of like a big step in my life personally, because it's a time where I moved out of my parents' house. So it's kind of like, it's a React video, but it's also kind of like my story, you know?
So this is finally happening.
Look at my room.
This is a thing.
I'm going back to this in 2 weeks.
PC. Oh my god, I just knocked over beer. That's incredible.
I'm going back to this in 2 weeks.
Oh my god.
I love America so much, and I'll be back next year to live full time. But I'm going back for now. Just for...
And then I go Belfast to London, and then London straight to LA. To the hundreds of thousands of people.
It's gonna make me cry.
You must go.
I'll be reunited with you soon, baby.
It was good having you. I'm stroking my curtains.
Welcome to my apartment.
I've been here ever since.
I'm going to show you guys around really, really quick, sort of show you what I got going.
Beautiful.
There's a few things that still have to come in the mail, but I'll just show you guys sort of what I've got now.
There's the couch.
So that's the door.
That was a big, big stage in my life.
Really, really less.
This is back in February.
Far less production value.
So if you guys are watching the full video of that, it's pretty much just going around my apartment and whatnot. And then we go forward to present day where you get videos like this. All right, what's going on? It's Vinny here and welcome to this react to old videos type vlog. So obviously there's a lot of videos there that I didn't include. Tell me what you guys think about this in the comments. This is kind of like, it's a nostalgia trip for me because it's always good to kind of reflect and sort of where you came from, where you are and sort of where you're going. Seriously though, from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you guys so much for tuning in. This YouTube ride has been an amazing journey so far. 4.5 years into this channel, 6 years so far. It's life-changing, you know? Like, I'm living in America off my own bat. I got a haircut because of YouTube. Who would have thought? No, but seriously, real talk. Like, you've made my life incredible. I've been given opportunities I never thought I would have been given before. I should be at university right now studying for my music degree, which is actually what I was going to go to university for. But I went for 2 weeks because I dropped out because of sort of YouTube and whatnot. Living in America, sort of making YouTube videos full time. It's still, for me, it still feels like a hobby, you know? One thing I'm going to get printed on my wall and like put on my wall is find a job you like and you never have to work a day in your life. And that's something that I seriously tell myself every day. Something that I live by every single day. And it is seriously because of you guys and watching my videos, supporting me, sort of liking my videos, commenting, watching everything. Liking my Twitter page, my Facebook, my Instagram, all that stuff, just supporting me in what I do and sort of making my dreams come true in a very cheesy way. It's true, it is cheesy, but it's true because I wouldn't be able to live that I've always wanted to live without you. So I know it's kind of a deep way to end this video, but seriously, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for everything you've done for me. Again, YouTube is nowhere near finishing. I don't see it finishing anytime soon, so we could do one of these, you know, we could do a recap of the year video, you know, I mean, maybe this time next year and the year after that, and we'll go from there. Who knows? It's kind of like, hey, people always ask questions, where do you see yourself next year? Where do you see yourself in 5 years? It's like, I don't even know what I'm doing tomorrow, you know, like life changes so much and you just can't predict it so much to the point where you really can't predict what's going to happen. So if it's seriously, like, I'm going to tell you guys this, and it's like, if you really want to do something, like, I know there's a lot of people out there, it's like, hey, I want to do YouTube, but I have this reason, that reason, that reason. It's like, to do what you want, you will have to sacrifice, you will have to sort of put yourself out there. But if you really, really want to do something, like, if you really want to make YouTube, like, who cares about people like, oh, but my mom or my friends might judge me for it. It's like, my friends judged me. My friends are like, I remember they found out when I was in 1,000 subs, they're like, Manny, what the hell are you doing? And I'm like, this is what I want to do. I can maybe, hopefully, see this going well someday. I want to give myself the chance. They're like, okay, Manny, that's really weird, but you can do what you want. And now they look at me and they're like, hey, Manny, you know what? You did what you wanted to do. You're living the life that you wanted to live. You know, and they commend me for it. And to hear the same people who judged me, you know, and it's like, fuck, hey, let's go. Hey, you're going to bring me down, you know? But it's kind of cool seeing the people who kind of judged me to begin with and now seeing and sort of commending me on it nowadays. It's touching and it's moving. I'm going to leave it like that. If you guys have anything you want to ask me in the comments, so whether it be like things I did YouTube-wise to sort of help me grow or anything you want, like I'm always here for you guys just the way you've been here for me. So I'm going to go through this question. I'm going to go through the comment section. I'm going to answer a lot of you guys' question on this. Anything you seriously have to ask, whether it be live questions or YouTube questions or anything, I want to be there for you as well as you've been here for me. So leave anything you want. Don't forget to leave a like to the video. Thank you all for watching. If you made it this far, it seriously is incredible that you decided to watch through all my bullshit and all my bad videos. But thank you all again. And if you're new here, welcome. You kind of just went a little history trip on my channel. Thank you all for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new here and want to become a lad. And like, subscribe, all that stuff. I'll talk to you guys in the next one.
This isn't me. This is not me.
You can't tell me what to do.
Oh my God. Does this look like a face of a man who is done or not?